Hi. Hey, how's it going, girl? I hope you're doing splendid.
Are you an oncoming train? Because this is all happening so fast.
Yeah, okay. Whose idea was it to make me start the video with a pickup line?
Yours, idiot.
Yeah, that would be the one. Welcome back to another discussion video, ladies and germs. This is a bit more of a relaxed environment than my more analytical stuff, but I still try to make like clear, concise points usually, but typically fail. So the topic of this discussion episode, I guess, is what's the next big thing gonna be in gaming? You know, like trends come and go, but sometimes they last for a really long time. Sometimes they can even solidify into something that lasts for decades and shows no sign of letting up, like multiplayer shooters. But I thought it'd be like a fun thing to do to try and figure out what the next big thing is gonna be based on our current trajectory with what's blown up previously. And of course, if you have your own opinions on this, leave them in the comments. I'd love to know your thoughts on it. So I think the first thing we need to do is look at the recent genre explosions and see if we can find some kind of common thread to follow and maybe extrapolate into what's going to come after and make qualifications, I guess, for something that fits into this like genre boom that I'm talking about is something that's either been introduced really recently and has hit the ground running and has absolutely taken off, or something that's been around for a really long time but just hasn't broken the barrier until recently. And for that second one, it has to be a pretty big difference in terms of how mainstream it's gotten in the past, say, decade, because I know you could probably make the case that something like Uncharted solidified and shaped story-driven third-person action games into what they are now. And games like Fallout 3 and New Vegas and Mass Effect did some sort of similar thing for RPGs, but you also had popular games in those genres before. And those games that I just mentioned were more like refinements to something that was already pretty well known. I would say the three biggest ones that we've had recently that fit that bill of a genre boom are Souls-likes, Battle Royales, and Roguelikes. The first one of those does use an existing framework in third-person melee, but it had enough outstanding elements to be given its own entire classification of games. And there are definitely games whose gameplay and look stray quite a bit from third-person melee and are still occasionally placed under that classification, so I think it's fair to say that it's a style of game that's gone from heavily underground to smack dab in front of your face. The original Demon's Souls, which was like the beginnings of this genre, sold 39,000 copies in its first week, and From Software's most recent game, Sekiro, sold 100,000 in its first day. We have very clearly seen a huge evolution of the mainstreamization, that's not a word, but I'm just gonna go with it, of that genre in recent years. I don't need to explain to you that battle royales have completely taken over the multiplayer market. Every big company wants their own: Epic, Ubisoft, EA, Activision. I mean, pretty early on, people entirely ditched the new Call of Duty for everything that wasn't zombies and just went back to Warzone. And I also think that Warzone is responsible for like the best fiscal year in Activision's history. Don't quote me on that, but I do think that they made the most amount of money off of Call of Duty last year than they ever had. Finally, the word that I've said probably 80 times in my last 5 videos, roguelikes. I guess my urge to finally talk about Hades coincided with Returnal's release and then wound up making me hate the word roguelike because I had to say it and hear it so many times during these videos, but I mean, I guess that kind of proves my point. I'd say this one is probably the weirdest progression that we've seen because it was basically unknown for so long, and then in the late aughts, early 10s, we kind of got like Spelunky, Binding of Isaac, Rogue Legacy, and it had a bit of a jump in interest, and then it subsided again, and then all of a sudden, now it's like every other indie game, and also now some big games are starting to be roguelikes. And honestly, I'm not complaining because I've fallen in love with the genre recently, so hey, the more the merrier. I do think that there is a through line between these three games, despite them being very, very different, and I think that it's not difficulty, but a constant checking of your skill. Some of this stuff is just straight up difficult, but at a base level, all three of these game types are designed to make you feel elated when you succeed by putting you through a heavy skill check. Whether it's beating a boss, or finally coming out on top in a match, or getting through a full run for the first time. You can even use cheap tactics to do this, like you can abuse enemy AI, or just like hide in a corner until everyone kills each other off, and you still feel more accomplished when you win in these games than you do in like every other game. You could be trying to hide for an entire match in Warzone, and somehow your competition ends up dying to the gas and you have zero kills, like you're trying to do a goddamn pacifist run, and I guarantee you, you will still be calling yourself goated. Don't lie, I've been there, okay? I've been on a team where they get 13 out of our 14 kills and we win, and I still think I'm hot shit. So yeah, being put through a skill check does seem to be on the incline, especially since we didn't really have many of those types of games in the past decade, like the one before this one. Mainstream games are actually becoming a lot tougher, I think. And I also feel like the most likely candidate for what's coming next next isn't going to be like something that comes out of nowhere. It's probably something that's kind of living in the background right now, and then there's going to be one or two games that really blow it up. It's not just going to be something like a Strand type game. Kojima came out and he was like, this is the first Strand type game. That genre is not really going to catch on. Like, it just kind of came out of nowhere and people are like, what? This feels very similar to ABC without DEF. So I don't think that's how it's going to go. In my opinion, the genre that's kind of being primed to make a splash soon is actually the rhythm action genre. Rhythm games have been around for a while, usually in the capacity of just timing button presses or holds at the right time, and also maybe using your body to do the same thing. But they've actually been injected with action a little bit more recently, and also some action games have started incorporating rhythm elements as well. The first example, we can see how games like Beat Saber and Pistol Whip took the basic hit something at the right time idea and gave you a gun or swords to slice through things or shoot at enemies. Pistol Whip especially seems like it's creeping closer to a full action game than most rhythm games before it. And yeah, this side of things is mostly blowing up in VR, but we can also see how the other way around, where action games are using rhythm elements, is starting to blow up in just normal games. We have BPM, which is a Doom style game that makes you shoot and reload to the beat. Crypt of the Necrodancer is a dungeon crawler that makes you time actions to the music, and Nintendo even took interest in the idea and made sort of a collab project with Zelda called Cadence of Hyrule. We can also see a more subtle version of this with the Souls games. I have a video up about Sekiro and its combat, and one of the things I mentioned was how it used rhythm elements without actual music in order to feel satisfying. And just in general, that kind of timing-based combat has a lot of the same logic as music. There's a Game Theory episode, I think, that came out a while ago that has a lot of in-depth discussions about how Souls combat times the same way as music does. It's pretty cool. Rhythm games do typically have difficulty levels, which is something that you don't really see in the three previous ones that we just talked about. But the thing is that if you're talking about difficulty, when you get to higher difficulties in rhythm games, it's more difficult than most other games out there. These things test you more than anything else. The whole idea is that you have to be perfect and very fast with all of your movements, and it makes you focus in a lot more than maybe any other type of game. It takes a serious amount of constant focus, so I feel like it actually is in line with that trend of rising difficulty that we're seeing in gaming. My guess is in a few years we're probably gonna see a game that's very similar to what Sifu looks like, except it has a lot of music elements. Sifu is a game that hasn't come out yet, but I'm just basing this on how it looks, where it's clearly a fast-paced, slightly more methodical version of a beat-em-up, with probably some more subtle rhythm elements like I mentioned for something like Sekiro, and I think that it'll be taken to the next step either by Slow Clap or by somebody else, by just adding an actual like music element behind it, giving it like an actual beat, and you have to time your attacks to the beat or blocks to the beat and stuff like that. And same with enemy attacks, they're also going to be to the beat. So then we end up with this like fully realized rhythm combat mechanic, and I think that people will really like that. Like, they'll see it and they'll really start to vibe with it and it'll take off. I really think that we're going to see that kind of develop over this console generation. It might not go exactly the way that I said it will, but I do feel like that fast hand-to-hand combat style really works well with rhythm. And I could just see that being a great marriage of the two genres, and that's how it'll actually end up going mainstream. Anyways, what I really want to know is what you guys think about this topic. My channel's at the point right now where I either get like dozens of comments or zero. So I have no idea how many people are going to watch this. I have no idea how many people are going to comment. But if you are watching this, hey, throw on your best guess or just your opinion on what I said. Maybe you think I'm a genius for coming up with this. Maybe you think I'm a stupid idiot who should quit. Either way, leave it down below. I will take a look at it, and hopefully I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.